The look and sound of the church has changed considerably over the years, growing and evolving as it meets the needs of its community. But while the Christian media has documented the development over the years, many like Kevin Newman, anchor of Global National News, would agree that the Canadian mainstream media hasn't always done the same.
Secular media in Canada and mainstream media tends not to report on issues of faith. And I think largely because most of the people who work in mainstream media tend to be secular. And so they assume that it's not much of an impact in people's lives. And that's just not true.
So with that in mind, Newman and a team from 90th Parallel, a production company in downtown Toronto, came up with the idea for a documentary, the second in a series entitled Revealed, that would investigate the growing evangelical church in Canada.
The number one reason why people don't go to church is because nobody invited them.
Hip to Be Holy is slated to air on May 25th on Global Television. Kevin Newman is the narrator.
I had lived and worked in the United States for about 7 years, and when I came back, I began seeing posters for the Alpha Club. And I was curious about it because it obviously had something to do with community. So I started looking into it a little bit more deeply and realized that it was a way to educate people about the Christian stories. And I thought that's really interesting because these signs are in places that surprise me. They're in storefronts. They're on people's front lawns. People are declaring their religious faith in a sort of uniquely Canadian, quiet way. Mm-hmm. And I thought something is changing in Canada, and I wonder what that is.
Hey,
thank you very much.
What they found, so nice. Says Karen Pinker, producer and director of the film, is a church unlike the one many Canadians thought existed.
The thing that surprised us most about this, I think, was the youth. The fact that this was very urban. I think we have a stereotype of who evangelicals are. And we thought, it's somebody living on a farm in outside Edmonton, somebody who's not out there in the world. And what we discovered, in fact, was this vitality amongst younger urban people. So that was pretty interesting to us. I'm gonna just
be honest with Throughout you. The hour-long special, we meet four people, all on different journeys, like Nate Gerber, a youth pastor who incorporates dance and music into his ministry.
I don't have to be afraid to say that I believe in Jesus, but I do have to wrestle with the ramifications of what people think that means.
Should I even give this God thing another try?
Pastor Kerry Newhoff from Barrie, Ontario, who has just broken away from his denomination and planted a new church called Connexus.
What we do is very strategic in that we try to take the easiest, the most obvious, and the most culturally relevant way we can to move people from a place of being curious about God to being in a real relationship with Jesus.
And Heather, a member of Connexus, who's dating Aaron, an atheist. They're a young couple that has to deal with issues of faith every day.
Yeah, we have had some tough times with that just because of different views on things. But I've said to Aaron that I want to raise my children in a Christian family. I want them to go to church with me. I want them to understand what being a Christian is and to have that as a large part of my household. So we've had lots of discussions surrounding that.
But the producers admit that the mainstream media's unfavorable skew on faith issues in the past created a challenge for them as they tried to gain the confidence of Christians in order to tell the story.
I spent a long time trying to gain the trust of our subjects, and understandably so, because I think people expect off the bat mainstream media is going to come in and do a hatchet job. So my standard line was, and I mean this honestly, I come not to blame nor to praise. No, I'm not working for Christian media, so I'm not here to promote you. This won't be an ad, but I'm not looking to take you down, as it were. Light rather than heat.
You don't see a lot of coverage about the good news that's happening in churches. If there's a moral failure or there's a financial scandal, it's all over the headlines. But the reality is that people are coming to faith, people are coming to Christ, and it's great to have somebody tell that story.
But that story, Newman says, also comes with many preconceived ideas of what church is all about. Notions formed from past experiences, and in some cases, carried on to the next generation.
I'm a baby boomer. I went to Sunday school. To be honest, I turned against organized religion in the church, And so I didn't educate my own children in the Christian stories. They don't know them. And I think that's where these new community churches, the evangelical strains of the church that are reaching out to that generation, are having an impact. Because they're telling people who are intrinsically interested in the story, because they see other friends who understand the stories of Islam or understand the stories of Judaism, and they don't know the Christian stories themselves. And so they're seeking them just for their own decision-making process about what do I believe? What is it that Christians believe? And out of all of the churches, it seems, in Canada, the Christian churches anyway, the evangelicals seem to be fairly successful at exporting the gospel to a place where people are willing to receive it.
That has been Carrie Newhoff's goal from the beginning. Starting Kinexus almost 2 years ago, his growing congregation currently meets in a movie theater. But he says while the locale might not be conventional, their belief in Jesus hasn't changed.
One of the things that I'm very passionate about is we're deeply wedded to Christ. We're deeply wedded to biblical authority. I mean, when you go to Kinexus, it seems different, but the reality is we just think the container needs to change.
And that's what struck Kevin and his team in their journey to understand what they call the new Christian church. Movie theaters, contemporary music, young people. Even though many Christians wouldn't consider this a new phenomenon, the Hip to Be Holy production team noticed a growing accessibility to the church that they feel wasn't there before.
Well, what struck me was how these new Christian churches were everywhere I looked, but I didn't know how to look for them.
Explain that.
Well, I have a cottage up in central Ontario. And I was walking on a main street, and I saw something in the window that said, notthenormalchurch.org. And I've seen other community churches that have sprung up, and they're large. And they're not called things that my generation recognizes as church, but they're church. And so the idea that there was this growing faith around me that I hadn't recognized because my eyes weren't open was intriguing to me.
What also caught his eye, Newman says, was how different the evangelical church in Canada is from the ones he was used to reporting on in the United States.
I had assumed that Canadian evangelicals would watch and learn from the United States and seek to export it here. And I think in the documentary we see how some people like Reverend Carey are kind of enamored by what's going on in Atlanta and are perhaps seeing that as the way. And then you have Nate, who isn't sure, you know, he sees the American church and the American version of the church, and he's a little put off by it, like some Canadians would be. And so what I learned through the process of the documentary and Karen's reporting was that it's still growing, it's still finding its voice.
And in the quest to find that voice, Karen Pinker hopes the stories and journeys of faith they highlight in Hip to Be Holy will cause discussion in this country we have yet to have.
We designed this always for a mainstream audience. You know, we wanted mainstream Canada to watch this. This was not something that we wanted to have only Christians. I want Muslims and Sikhs and Christians and atheists and agnostics to look at this and then have a discussion about it. Maybe that's the thing lacking in Canada. We're not able to discuss religion.
I hope at the end that people see believers. People see people who are passionate about their faith, who are trying to communicate their faith in realistic, modern ways, who have ideas that maybe not in the mainstream, especially on perhaps same-sex marriage in Canada, but who are recognizing that that they can still have influence in the political process, perhaps in more sophisticated ways. And that was another thing that I found interesting, that evangelicals aren't saying it's my way or the highway. They are coming at political issues with, well, this is what we believe, but there still seems to be an openness for discussion and debate.
Revealed, Hip to Be Holy will air on global television on May 25th. You can check your local listings for airtimes. In Toronto, Ontario, Magdalene John, 100 Huntley Street.